Hello, my friends. This is Wolfgang with Tools for Ascension. And today's meditation is about throat and neck problems. So practically everybody that I worked with that was powerful and psychic, or maybe you would say sensitive, had strong negative energies, you know, in their throat, in their brainstem and neck area. Many times, you know, these energies manifest as headaches or migraines during stressful situations. Of course, you know, some experience what could be described as claustrophobic feelings around the throat and neck area. There are also chronic throat issues like hoarseness, you know, throat infection, or an inability to speak up. I have visited too many past lifetimes, or even in this lifetime, where we were silenced as children, you know, by yelling and harsh judgment, you know, or as adults, you know, we were also silenced, you know, and in many ways, sometimes, you know, harsher than just words, you know. From a martial arts point of view, you know, it is very easy to kill somebody through the neck, you know. if done right, you know, it can be silent, you know, and there is no danger of busting up your knuckles. So, and some of you may wonder, you know, if I have gone spastic. So this was like a neck chop, you know, and that means lights out, you know. And this one, you know, is a neck break, and that means, you know, lights out, you know, permanently. And then this here, you know, is a throat punch, you know, and lights are dimming fast, you know, after one of those. So, and that was just without weapons. And imagine, you know, by bare hands, if you want to kill somebody without affecting this air, how much work you have to go through, right? So statistically, you know, the neck is like the place, you know, to hurt somebody, you know. And so then there is this very common stuff, like, you know, with tools like head chopping, throat cutting, strangulation, hanging, drowning, suffocation, you know, through pillows, sand, fire, ritual neck cracking, and lots of cordings also, you know, to steal energy, you know, just to name a few. And, you know, I'm not into fear, you know, whatever, you know, all those things that already have happened to you, you know. And so now we are becoming more aware of those things as we are starting to go into the astral, becoming more aware of those things. Because the vibration is rising, you know, so it's time to deal with it, and then we move beyond this, you know. But it's right now, it's time, as we're moving through the astral, to dump, you know, a lot of these baggages, you know, and then our connection to a higher guidance becomes clearer, and then we can transcend much easier, or go to the fifth dimensional consciousness, you know. So then there are also magical implants that are more plentiful and variegated than what has been seen in horror and torture movies, you know. I mean, again, nothing to be scared about, you know, because you already have them. But you know, there is some nasty stuff that that has been invented, right? And so, as we are clear, you know, layer after layer, you know, of these things, our resilience, you know, and of course also our life force increases, you know, and the physical symptoms disappear, you know. In some cases, you know, this can happen instantly, you know, especially, you know, when soul fragments or ghosts are being released, you know. So I've seen this several times. You know, especially around the neck, you know, and the ghost leaves that had neck issues, you know, poof, wow. without touching anything, you know. Oh God, I have been suffering from this ghost all my lifetime, you know. Now the neck is suddenly okay. So this, some of those things can go instantly. It's not a miracle, you know. There is a good explanation when you understand what's going on, you know. So. And then, of course, you know, there is like past life trauma, and I think this is important for you to understand. You know, for example, you know, one lady with chronic neck and throat problems, you know, came to me for help. Let's call her Tusnelda. And so, you know, I raised Tusnelda vibration, and we asked her high self, you know, to please show us, you know, the main reason for her neck and throat problems, you know. And so Tusnelda, you know, went into a past life and saw that she was a Native American young male, you know, in a previous lifetime. And so he happened to discover a herd of white mustangs and, you know, proceeded to catch himself a nice horse. Unfortunately, he got stuck in a booby trap, you know. It turned out the horses were not wild, but owned and protected by these traps. A kind of lasso, you know, had caught his head, pulled him off the horse, and dangled him by the neck till he was dead, you know. He tried to call for help, which for obvious reason, you know, could not be heard. So we asked Tusnelda's high self, you know, if there was any pattern from this incident besides the obvious neck pain that was still affecting her in this lifetime. So the pattern, turns out, was she could not ask for help. You know, it was even miraculous for her to seek help for me, you know. She has always felt very, you know, isolated in her problems. And I knew from experience that in a strangling situation, you know, the pain cannot be expressed, you know, and thereby released in a cry. You know, when you cry out, you know, when you hurt yourself, a lot of this chi is being released, you know, so it's helpful to cry and release it instead of suppression. So, you know, I had Tusnelda do a long releasing cry mentally, you know, of course, you know, just in her mind, you know, you don't want the cops coming knocking at your door. So, it happened to me once. I mean, the cry, the cops didn't come, but I was, that was scary. So the cry helped to release much of the energy that was stuck in her throat, and then the rest was released, you know, with intent after the ghost of that Native American young male, you know, was released home into the higher dimensions, you know. So, and of course, you know, those symptoms disappeared during the session. I mean, generally, you know, the body definitely has to heal and adapt itself, you know, but definitely, you know, the physical body definitely gets affected by the subtle force field, you know. Just like, you know, a electromagnetic force field, you know, directs, you know, iron particles, you know, into these patterns. Similar, you know, the ethers, you know, kind of arrange molecules you know, and arrange them accordingly through the DNA, you know, but it's going also through force fields. So another category of neck and throat trauma, you know, comes from speaking your divine truth, you know. Remember, you know, all those wonderful activities that the Catholic Church performed during the witch hunts, you know, to spread the love of Jesus Christ, you know. usually those that were spiritually connected to divinity and tried to help, you know, their ignorant fellow human beings, you know, either through herbs, hands-on healing, or other potential spiritual, potent spiritual assistance, you know, got tortured, you know, by these so-called disciples of Christ, you know. And my intuition tells me, you know, through all this past life regressions that I've done, that these people knew exactly what they were doing. You know, they knew that the trauma of torture would cripple the connection to their high selves, you know, in the future incarnations, you know. So when our crown chakra is opened, you know, we can access spiritual guidance, you know, which is broken down, you know, it coming in, you know, into thought forms, you know, like visions, concepts, feelings, you know. By the third eye, you know, this is the pineal gland, it's one of those translation centers, you know. And then these realizations can then be expressed, you know, when the throat chakra is opened, you know, otherwise you cannot communicate about those things, you know. And light workers, you know, throughout time, you know, had the unpleasant job to speak up and show mass mind, you know, where there was still room for improvement, you know, and maybe it wasn't necessarily mass mind, maybe it were the one percenters that didn't like, you know, where what was shown. So do mass mind and the status quo, you know, like these divine messengers? Well, you know, the story of Jesus, you know, probably serves as a well-known example of what happens to those that speak up and have potency. You know, many so-called, also, you know, let's say, pagan witches and healers, you know, followed in, you know, the same footsteps, you know, got, you know, crucified, tortured, you know, man, you know, by following their spiritual intuition and divine compassion. And yet, you know, if you get tortured and killed every time, you know, you express divine truth, it causes a conditioning, you know. Every time I speak divine will, I get killed and tortured. You know, we better shut up and shut down the throat chakra so that will not happen again. Mm-hmm. So every time, you know, this person comes to a certain level of spiritual awakening and higher truth speaking, you know, the past trauma of being remembered and the fear of being tortured again, you know, comes up and we self-sabotage and shut down in fear. You know, lots of this, you know, yeah, you know, I'm making spiritual progress and then boom, so I start just eating white bread. And do nothing, you know, overeat. So anyhow, so where we self-sabotage. So I know this topic seems to be a bit on the negative side, but let us be realistic, you know. History as we know it, you know, was not kind, you know, but extremely cruel and predatory, you know. And to think that all this pain has just gone away, you know, is an illusion. So people carry around their old pain and it cripples them and their ability to experience happiness and love. You know, all these layers of all psychic pain, you know, are lifted off the person, you know. As they are lifted off the person, you know, the natural capacity for bliss emerges. You know, and the mystic yogis, you know, and I mean, Hatha Yoga, you know, is really the lowest step of the yogic ladder, you know. So mystic yogis call this process, you know, of achieving liberation, you know, becoming a liberated soul. Jivan Mukta. Jivan means soul, Mukta means liberated. Uh-huh. So this coming guided meditation is a shotgun meditation, you know, designed to hit a lot of points, you know, even at a low skill level. So if you think you need outside help, you know, I'm available for private Skype consultation, you know, but try this first. And so before we go on to the guided meditation, I just want to point out, you know, some principle that I found will support the success of any guided meditation. Mm-hmm. So sit on a comfortable office chair and balance your body so that everything stacks up nicely. You know, it's very difficult to enjoy bliss, you know, when your back hurts or when you're slumping. Yeah. And so use earbuds, you know, or headphones to cancel out outside distractions, you know, and also take advantage of the sound quality. You know, it makes, you know, a big difference, you know. The effect is not the same when you hear it off a squeaky phone speaker, all right? And of course, do not drive or operate heavy machinery. You know, I have to say that. And smile like an idiot and reside in your heart. You know, you will not have access to higher dimension, you know, unless you vibrate at a certain love frequency. Mm? And breathe at a pace that you can hear the air flowing through your nostrils. So like this. You know, so you breathe all the way in, all the way out. You know, it's called the three-step breath. You know, diaphragm, ribcage expanding, ribcage lifting. You know, singers know about this. So, you do not have to repeat my affirmations. You know, just think or say amen. You know, when I say amen, you know, but mean it. And also be in a childlike state of innocence during the guided meditation, you know. Just pay attention to what pops into your mind, but do not judge or try to rationalize it, you know, at the moment. You know, once you, then you're there and then you're off, you know, you're speculating on the mental plane, you know. So always, you know, stay in the heart, you know, and then later on, you know, you can speculate about it. So, and if you have a turquoise around, you know, you can get cheap turquoise necklaces, you know, with tumbled stone, just, you know, put it around your neck, maybe have a purified, you know, before. So, expect a subtle or not so subtle shift of energy, you know, after within 5 seconds of setting an intent. So whenever we do amen, you know, you can expect that, and I sometimes use a pendulum, you know, to show me when a release is done, you know, and make sure, you know, either your awareness is centered above the head, you know, or in your throat, or best in your heart, you know, but don't worry, you know, just don't be here, and be playful. You know, and you know, if you feel something releasing, you know, just smile into this and support it. You know, just support any clearing. You can even use your hands if you want to. You know, just release it. You know. Okay, so close your eyes, and now we ask for we connect actually. You know, with the absolute, you know, source of everything, the highest being, and also our own highest self, you know, our inner child, our guardian angels, our spirit guides, you know, and all the incarnation that can help and support us, you know, as well as our star tribes, you know, coming from unconditional love, you know, the higher dimensionals that support the human ascension, you know, and we ask also for the presence of fifth dimensional Gaia and of course of Milky Way galaxy. And we ask that everything that happens in and from the session here is going to be for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes throughout all time, incarnations, localities and dimensions. Amen, 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 amen. We also ask that there is no deception, Mm-hmm. Amen. And that we are completely protected on all levels. Amen, 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 amen. And now smile like an idiot and send your roots into the earth. Just imagine that you shapeshift your legs into your spine, into this big taproots. They just glide into the earth and just split off into smaller and smaller and get fringed. And through them, you know, you open up to Mother Earth's love that just rises in you. It just flows up in you, up your spine, maybe squirting even out of the top of the head, and maybe out of your fingertips. Let it flow into your fingertips and out of your fingertips. And we ask that any blocks and cords that, you know, block or siphon off the energy of the earth, please be removed from you without having to look at details as much as possible now. Amen. And you probably feel that lift in energy. And just smile like an idiot and just, you know, breathe it up your spine. Let it pop out the top of the head. And now let that go all the way up to the Milky Way galaxy that you imagine above your head. Just say hello to your higher dimensional aspects and relations that you're having there. And on the inhale, you know, allow their love to flow into you, surround you, flow through you. And also, you know, share with the Mother Earth. So you're in between this loving exchange where the earth energy flows up into the higher dimensions and where the higher dimensional energy flows, you know, through you, over you, into these earth dimensions. And all for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen. Yes, just smile like an idiot. And the more you breathe and the sweeter you smile, the more wonderful the energy. And allow that your body be cleansed, you know, also all your subtle body with those loving, wonderful chi vibrations that flow through and over. And now we ask Source and Archangel Michael or anybody else who is qualified. You know, we all have different traditions and different relations, you know. But so, for instance, we can ask Lord Shiva for those in the Hindu tradition, you know, to remove as much as possible any Anunnaki, Draco, Grey or other predatory cords and devices and any other technology from every level of our being, any incarnation, all time or dimensions, now for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen, 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 amen. And just smile and breathe and observe the shift in energy. Stay connected with heaven and earth, reside in the heart. And now, you know, just allow those earth energies that are coming up and those heaven energies that are coming down to also open up the lotus flower in your heart. With so many beautiful petals, you know, that are subtle. You know, it's more like a feeling for many of you, you know, these are beautiful emotional expansions, like fluffy little feelings in the chest area. And breathe into it and smile into it. And maybe you become aware of all the sweet sublime energies and sensations that can be felt even they get energized. Okay. So that was kind of an emotional connection, and now we go on the high speed internet connection with the Milky Way. So we imagine that there is kind of like a beam of light from our head going all the way to the center of the Milky Way galaxy consciousness, which goes through us and then all the way to the core of the Earth Mother. So we're just in between the strong connection. And smile and notice how you, like, you have a certain buzz in your spine. Yeah, it wakes you up. It's, you know, definitely wide awake. And so we also ask and allow this light to dissolve any blocks or blobs or clouds of darkness that are not even needed now. Amen. Yeah, clearing the spine is very, very important. You know, when that is cleared, many back problems disappear automatically. Not all, but many. And now allow that liquid love and light into your neck, you know, where it's tight. You know, to dissolve any pain or darkness that you can detect. And smile like an idiot. This is how you dial in the love. And smile into those tense, traumatized areas in your neck. And now also you're going deeper and deeper into your heart. And connect to Source through your heart. Goes from source to soul, and from soul it filters, you know, to your human awareness level, huh? And it percolates out the heart from the higher dimensions. Yes, let that heart come out, can't let love come out. All right. And now, let's ask our high self to step into our body, our higher consciousness, as much as possible. Amen. And some of you may feel how you appear to be taller, nicer, lighter, just better, right? And so yeah, that's your high self. So anyhow, you know, we don't have to necessarily feel this. So now let's ask the high self to show us what a yes would be. And for many of us, it will just be the energy flows up from heart up into your higher chakras. But there could be other things, you know, like a smile coming over your face. Huh? That would be a good yes too. Or seeing a thumbs up in your mind's eye, right? And let's ask that we be shown how a no would look like or feel like. Many times it's just the energy going from heart down to the lower chakras, and a more depressed feeling coming over us. Or you may feel more like frowning. Oh, you get a thumbs down. All right. So now let's ask whether we are still carrying trauma from throat cutting, stabbing, you know, and assassinations like that. Yes or no? And also ask now whether you did the same things to other people in your past lifetimes, yes or no. And now we ask the highest to please, the highest, most, like Lord Shiva in the Hindu tradition. Let's just stick with this, otherwise you just say source. Archangel Michael would be good too, right? To please, you know, bring those ghosts that are still stuck from those traumas, you know, on either side, to bring them home, guide them home into the higher vibration, clear them of their trauma and their curses, show them how much happier they will be. And please remove the trauma throughout all incarnation, all time, all dimensions, and all localities. In the future I'm gonna call those things, you know, all over creation. Otherwise it gets too long. Amen. Alright. And if you feel like cranking your neck, you know, do so gently. You know, you don't have to be stiff, you know, you might even, you know, move your spine around. Just do whatever feels good. And we ask, you know, that high self and healers, you know, whatever is helping us, you know, may continue till this is finished. And now let's ask whether we also have neck and throat problems and trauma from arrows, lances, you know, like battles. Yes or no? And let's ask whether we did this also to other people. Yes or no? And so we give forgiveness and ask for forgiveness. And again, we ask Lord Shiva or Source to please return those lost soul fragments or ghosts home into the higher vibrations, into the heavens, and transmute any trauma, etc., all negative patterning throughout creation. Amen, 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 amen. And now we ask whether there's still some trauma with us from hanging, strangulation, garrote, and suffocation. Yes or no? And also ask if you did those things to others in past lifetimes. Yes or no? Okay, so now go ahead and ask for forgiveness and give forgiveness, and we ask Source or Lord Shiva to please guide those soul fragments and ghosts, you know, into the higher vibration, into the heavens. And please clear, you know, all the trauma throughout creation. And we ask Lord Brahma, you know, with everything that has been cleared, this is also be healed by Lord Brahma. Amen, amen, amen. Oh, Source. Oh, get your archangels in there. You know, they know what they're good at. So they're all invited. Okay. Let's ask, you know, also whether there was crushing or pouring down of lead or other oil or other nasty things down the throat. Yes or no? And also, if he did this to others in past lifetimes, yes or no. And he asked divinity to please, you know, bring those lost souls home into the higher vibration. And please, Lord Shiva, transmute all the karma, all the curses, all the negativity, all the trauma throughout creation. Amen, 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 amen. And of course, everything, you know, again, is supposed to happen for the highest good in divine harmony with the most benevolent ones. Okay, so let's ask, you know, whether we also keep and hold trauma from being suppressed in our free expression by our parents, you know, or authorities, like teachers. Yes or no? And ask if you did the same thing to others. Yes or no? And now ask for forgiveness and give forgiveness. And we ask that Source, Lord Shiva, brings the soul fragments home into heaven and clears all the bad karma and trauma throughout our creation. Amen, 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 amen. And while this is going on, ask whether you still carry trauma from suppression of your free expression from local group consciousness, right? Where you didn't fit into the religion or you weren't in the right club, you're an outsider, you know, had a different, maybe better point of view. People were challenged by you, you know. So that didn't always go down that well. Do you have trauma as such? Yes or no? And let's ask if you also in past lifetimes, you know, suppressed others, you know, when they were speaking the truth or they were speaking something that you didn't like, but which was true, you know. Ask that, yes or no? And now we ask forgiveness and give forgiveness, and we ask Source and Lord Shiva to please release any trapped ghost or soul fragments now to heaven, and clear any karma, trauma, etc., spells, curses, throughout creation now. Amen, 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 amen. And now ask if you have any inherited stuck emotions. You know, this many times, you know, our mama got pregnant. Or knocked up, you know, to describe it in a poetic way, and was freaking out, you know, and so this can affect the baby that takes this kind of emotion as a baseline, right? Or, you know, mama was very depressed, you know, all her life, you know, and the baby gets born into a womb like that. This is again, you know, an inherited emotion. Or maybe, you know, your tribe or your family got cursed and they're all very anxious or bitter or depressed. You know, that's just the mood they are. They always have been like that. right? So that is another inherited emotion, you know, through coming through, you know, your ancestors. So, are you carrying significant amounts of those, yes or no? And also, you know, are you doing this to others? You know, passing on bad emotional habits onto your family, onto your kids, onto your people that are around you? Or did you do so in past lifetimes? Did you contaminate the emotional pool of your ancestors in past lifetimes? Yes or no? Alright, so we asked for forgiveness and give forgiveness and ask Source or Lord Shiva to please, you know, bring all those soul fragments home and clear all the trauma and karma, you know, throughout our creation now. Amen, amen. Alright, now let's ask whether we are still affected by vows of silence, you know, for spiritual reasons. You know, in many traditions, vows of silence, you know, were done, like the Trappist monks, you know, among the Christian, though those guys had talked to fairies. And all kinds of beings, just not humans, so they're not really silent. But anyhow, and you know, yogis, you know, yogis in Hinduism is called maunam, you know, because, you know, you can spend a lot of energy, nervous energy, just by chit-chatting around. And if you do not speak at all, you know, you save a lot of energy, you increase your life force, and when you speak, you know, it's gonna have a lot of potency. Yeah, plus you have like a quadrillion little muscles in your tongue that you need for speaking. And so, you know, each tiny muscle needs as much nervous energy to get triggered as, you know, one of your huge biceps or glutes. So, you know, you burning a lot of nervous energy in your tongue. So all this can be harvested and saved, and it was done for good reason under certain circumstances. But nowadays things have changed, and so we ask that those vows be cleared if it's for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen, amen. And of course, you know, we also ask if we, you know, if we, you know, were promised vows of silence when we were masters, spiritual masters or authorities, you know, that were done, you know, so we release those too, of course. Amen, 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 amen. And there were also vows of silence, you know, that were given to sacred orders, you know, doctrines, secret knowledge, or just, for instance, you know, when you have confession, you know, that this was not spoken about, you know, there were all kinds of vows of silence, and so this might still hinder you nowadays to speak the truth, you know, though it's pretty much common knowledge, you know, or to bring in concepts that are very much needed nowadays. And so we asked Source, you know, that these please be, you know, released, you know, from us, these vows, and also from those that we asked those vows, you know, to be taken, you know, so they owe us that contract, so we release those too. You know, as long as it is for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes, you know, and we ask that this be done throughout creation. Amen, 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 amen. You know, and I mean with the purpose that we can speak, you know, for healing and for the upliftment, you know, of everybody. Amen, you know. The embodiment of the divine. So, and then let's us ask, you know, whether we got silenced, you know, through punishment and torture for speaking the truth, you know, because we had insights, maybe we had visions, or we were just smart and, you know, like mention about the emperor's clothes. you know, so we asked that these traumas please be released so we can speak the truth whenever it's for the highest good. And also where we, you know, we jumped and other people and punished them when they were speaking truth that we didn't hear, want to hear, you know, so we also asked them, want them released, we asked for forgiveness, we give forgiveness, we forgive ourselves also for being such jerks, and yes, we ask that this all be cleared and released, the ghost brought to heaven, and the trauma being released throughout all creations, amen. And then another category of being silenced, you know, which still affects the throat energy, you know, the throat chakra, is being silenced due to blackmail. You know, if you speak up, you know, we are going to kill everybody that you love, you know, in front of you or in front of each other, you know, or in front of the kids, you know, and somehow you get so traumatized, you know, that you have a huge block, you know, due to this fear. And sometimes even they got killed, you know, and then on top of it we have trauma. And sometimes we did this to other people, and so there is also bad blood there, you know. So let's just ask, did this happen to us, yes or no? And did we do it to others, yes or no? Okay, so now we ask for forgiveness, give forgiveness. We ask that Source, Lord Shiva, bring home the ghost into heaven. And we asked for a karma, trauma clearing throughout creation now. Amen, 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 amen. And there's another category of throat issues, and I'm going through all those details because I found that when you just go blanket throat issues, that's not good enough. Maybe you get a little result, but they want you to do your homework, they want you to have insight, right? And so it is much better when you realize, you know, how much of this and how much due to that you have, right? And that's why are we still affected from past life neck injuries, you know, by accidents like falling off a horse, car accident, whiplash, you know, sports, things like that, yes or no? And also ask whether we caused other people to have accidents like that, yes or no? And so, you know, we apologize and, you know, forgive. And we ask that any stuck ghosts and soul particles please be brought home, released. And he asked that any dark karma as well as trauma, please be cleared throughout our creation. Amen, 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 amen. And let's ask now, while this is going on, whether we also, you know, carry throat trauma from past lifetimes due to disease, like throat infection, right? Yes or no? And we like to have that cleared. And oh, maybe even we have bad karma by infecting others, right? So a lot of the Americas, you know, got cleared by so-called white people infecting the native populations, whose immune system, you know, weren't updated, you know, to the levels that people from the gutters of London and Madrid and other places came from. Yeah, so there might be karma, you know, for some of those people, and so he asked for a clearing of all those ghosts and soul fragments that are still around. Please get them into heaven. Sorry it took so long. And he asked for forgiveness and give forgiveness, and ask for a transmutation of all this trauma through our creation. Amen, 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 amen. Now that was all the light stuff. Now we go to the darker stuff. Ooh. So, black magic curses, and if you think that black magic doesn't work or wasn't used, you know, you are naive, you are Pollyanna all the way through. Yep, you know, this has been used, you know, for long times. It works, and the powerful still use it, you know, and it creates a big mess, you know, and all the cultures, they have black magic, you know. Many times it's the poor ones, the weak ones, you know, where there is no other way of getting even or defending themselves, you know, those that have nothing to lose. So, and we all kind of walked on the dark side too. Most of us probably did, you know. If you if you think you didn't, you are probably suffering from spiritual pride. And should use the pendulum and be really unbiased, you know, and be humble and, you know, accept maybe the fact that you also have failed in the past, right? And it's not a failure at all, so it's just part of soul evolution. So otherwise we are just all armchair philosophers, right? So so are we, is our throat negatively affected by black magic curses, yes or no? Amen. And also, did we affect others through black magic curses, yes or no? So let's ask for forgiveness, give forgiveness. Let's ask Lord Shiva and Source to please transmute all those curses throughout creation. And we ask for healing of the damage, a reconstitution to the divine blueprint, whatever is most appropriate throughout creation. Amen, 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 amen. We are so sorry about all this stuff. And now we have another biggie one here. You know, it's from the far side, but oh boy, this happens a lot. I'm not making this up. I see thousands of past lifetimes. I've seen a lot of this stuff happening. So ask whether, you know, you have throat issues because you know, the energy from your throat is being stolen, you know. In other ways, are your talents and your resources being stolen, you know, through cords or tubes or other means, yes or no? And you might even ask, how many percent of your throat force is being stolen? Now, and now ask if you are also, you know, stealing, you know, from other people, and this is many times probably from past lifetimes, you know, where you set this up, you know, or even maybe this lifetime, or, you know, it's subconscious. I mean, you're not saying, you know, you are bad, you know, this just happens. So, but ask, you know, so are you also taking throat chakra energy from other people, yes or no? And now, just give forgiveness and ask for forgiveness. And we ask Source and Lord Shiva to please transmute all, you know, those things, remove them. You know, attach the people to their own source of power, you know, to Source again. And if there are any ghosts or contracts that are, you know, based on cheating, please bring them home and cancel those contracts, those cheating contracts. I don't gonna go into details here, but Source knows. Yeah, please clear those throughout creation. Amen, 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 amen. And here's more of the dark side. Ask whether you have, you know, alien, you know, which could be like just space alien, you know, or Alpha Draconian, or Zeta, or reptilian implants and cords into your neck area and throat area that affects you in a negative way, yes or no? And she asked, you know, whether maybe in some incarnations, you know, we are also on those levels, incarnated in those races, and are harvesting this kind of stuff, yes or no? Alright, let's be fair, you know, so we asked that, you know, the sucking on us be cleared, and that where we suck on others also be cleared, to be fair. And also any contracts around those suckery be cleared, because most likely they're all based on cheating. And if you look at them, you know, they're based on cheating. You know, it wasn't delivered what was promised, it wasn't explained properly. So, you know, it's the higher sources now. So we just ask that they be cleared. Amen. And that all the karma, you know, all the trauma around these be cleared throughout creation. Amen, 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 amen. And now ask, this is another far out one, but it's very common, very, very common. Whether you have a misalignment of your subtle bodies in the throat and, you know, that whole neck area, you know, where your subtle bodies are, you know, abducted, you know, pulled apart and then messed with, and then not even realigned properly, you know, asked whether this actually happens to you, whether you have trauma from this, yes or no. And if yes, we ask that these kind of abuse of technology and free will please be brought to the highest court of spiritual arbitration and justice. And, you know, we would like, you know, to have this trauma removed, you know, and by the highest and best. And then, you know, the subtle bodies repaired and realigned by the highest and best. Amen, 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 throughout creation. Amen, 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 amen. And now we ask if there are any cord attached, you know, to the telepathic channels that you have at the back of your head and neck, you know, through which your higher perception is being manipulated, you know, and where also your energy is being stolen, yes or no? And also ask whether you're doing such things, you know, with others. Is this probably most likely past lifetime stuff? Hopefully, if you do this consciously in this lifetime, you are bad. And of course now, you know, we ask for forgiveness, we give for forgiveness, and we ask for transmuting of those cords, make sure they're not getting reattached throughout all creation. Amen, 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 amen. Now ask whether your neck and head area is affected by implants, you know, like done through voodoo dolls, like pins, glass, spikes, you know, things that are done on a kind of a primitive type of magic like this, yes or no? And ask whether you've done so to others in past lifetimes, yes or no? Uh-huh, and now, of course, we give forgiveness, ask for forgiveness, and we ask for a clearing of the damage, of the karma, throughout incarnation, throughout dimensions, localities, and time, and of course we ask that all the soul fragments and ghosts be brought home. Amen, 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 amen. So, there's a lot more now. Let's do this bulk and fast. So again, you know, we asked Source and Archangel Michael and Lord Shiva to please break any contracts, you know, where we gave consent, you know, to be implanted, you know, due to trickery, and, you know, and where we were actually not given or delivered what was promised, you know. So we asked that please those contracts, you know, be cleared through our time, you know. And now these are the items, we like to have them cleared, and when we put them into others, we also like to have this cleared, you know, throughout, you know, our creation, you know. But let's also ask whether you have been affected by those, you know. Are there chains, yes or no? So we asked for clearing of those, you know, with all aspects, you know, whether it's ghosts, soul fragments, karma, you know, the whole nine yards. Mm-hmm. Are there ropes? Yes or no? Again, we like to have a complete clearing on our creation. Are there cages? Yes or no? again a complete clearing. Are there casts and molds? Yes or no? And of course we ask for complete clearing. Are there clams? Yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. Are there rings? Yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. Are there reverse crowns? Yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. Are there masks? Yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. Are there still negative sucking cords? Yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. Are there negative seeds? Yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. Is there still any way through which energy is stolen? Yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. Are there any plates, especially ones that separate head from shoulder and head from high self? Are there any plates? Yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. Are there any metal spikes or screws or rods? Yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. And are there many other devices or methods not mentioned here, but that spirit knows are harmful and illegal against the free will, and that harm us, yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. Also, are there any critters attached, like ghosts or archons, little astral entities, yes or no? And we ask for complete clearing. Are there still any ghosts left that haven't gone home? Yes or no? And we ask for ascension teams to please bring them home. You know what to do by now. Amen. And now, as a final wipe up, I release all other unmentioned resistances that I hold in my throat on a physical, emotional and spiritual level that prevent me from releasing stuck emotions and traumas from this and past lives. Please, Source, Lord Shiva, my spirit guides, find all, remove all and clear all throughout all time, incarnations, dimensions and locations, and continue to finish, as long as it is for the highest good in divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. And now come back into your body, start wiggling your toes, breathe into your heels and fingers. Come in centered into your heart and smile like an idiot if you not already are, you know. And, you know, remember, no driving or operating heavy machinery, you know, at least not after this meditation for a while. So I count to three and you will be back in waking day consciousness. 1, 2, 3. Hey friends. Welcome back. So please, you know, drink a lot of water afterwards. You know, so parallel to the release of emotional toxins, you know, your body will release, of course, chemical toxins, you know, according to the principle, as above, so below, you know. So if this shotgun meditation rocked your boat, you know, a private session will blast your socks off, you know, or if you need any help with any issues, you know, I work over Skype, just send me an email, you know. So also my meditations are available for free at all major podcast stations. Just do a search under Tools for Ascension by Wolfgang and that stuff come up, you know. And of course, you know, subscribe, ring the bell and, you know, spread the love, smile like an idiot. I love you. Namaste.